It's March 21st, 2024. I'm at the World Health Organization with Luis Villarroel.
Villarroel.
Yes, I'm sorry. With Innovarte. And Luis, I'd like you to first introduce yourself. Tell people who you represent, why you came to Geneva this week, how you think negotiations are going, and what advice you have to negotiators.
Thank you, James, for this interview. As you have asked me, my name is Luis Villarroel. I am the director of an NGO that does capacity building and technical assistance on intellectual property matters with a view of development. We are based in Chile, but we work mainly in Latin America and as well as international organizations, multilateral organizations here in Geneva. And we are here because we are concerned of making the best of an opportunity for the world to improve safety and health for all continents in case of a new pandemic. The idea of countries coming together to agree on a collaboration to enhance, you know, preparedness and response in case of a pandemic, it seems like an excellent idea, and especially after the experience that we have with COVID. So we are here because we want to contribute to the understanding and the implication of alternative provisions in the instrument. In particular, we believe that the principles of equity, solidarity are key to this instrument, especially because in matters of health, the equity that will allow everyone to have access to medical countermeasures in case of a pandemic is also an element for safety of everyone. So, getting the response equally around the world allows, you know, that the virus and pathogens are controlled, you know, faster. So it's a matter of interest, not only for countries who might need special assistance to have access, but also for the countries who are, you know, naturally closer to the countermeasures. And we are deep worried that these principles of equity and solidarity are being or asked to be removed by the, you know, by the content of what is in discussion. We are shocked that a country has been, you know, asking to remove the word solidarity, you know, from the text. And also we are concerned as well that countries that could be defending more the needs of access are more silent than we would have expected. So we think that this treaty is needed, but we see that the right approach to the content is being derailed by I don't want to be wrong, but it's being derailed by some more selfish interest than the well-being of humanity.
Luis, Has anything else surprised you this week?
Can you give me light on what are you thinking? I guess surprised.
Well, you've been involved in quite a few negotiations, and so coming in, you maybe had certain expectations about what would happen this week. But are there things that you've seen being on the ground here that surprised you beyond what you've already discussed?
Well, I believe that not believe is the word, but I'm disappointed of the level of secrecy that these discussions are going. I cannot believe that the stakeholders who have been accredited by member countries, as here we call it Annex E, we are not allowed to listen to what the countries are discussing. It doesn't make any sense. It's like you call doctors to support a patient, and the doctors are not allowed to talk to the patients, and so we are surprised and disappointed to say that civil society is sort of like wasted in the expertise, as it's it's only a matter of, you know, personal relations or some countries that are, you know, more open, that civil society is able to intervene. But it's crazy. I mean, like, people fly, you know, to come here, and they are kept in the cafeteria with no access to information. And it reminds me there is a myth of Platon, is called the cave, where people is inside a cave and they try to figure out what happens in the outside world and only see shadows. And here, that's how our civil society. And I think it's unspeakable in a UN agency.
How would you compare this to the way the World Intellectual Property Organization operates in terms of the transparency?
Well, I think that shockingly, it, at least in this negotiation, is closer. I mean, it's more closed door than will be a negotiation in the World Intellectual Property Organization, and that's something that is mind blowing, because this is an organization, the UN agency, that is has an objective of health and humanity, not commercial interest like will be WIPO, and yet it seems that discussions are kept in secret, like we were talking about nuclear weapons or some really dangerous matter. We are talking about health, we are talking about access to vaccine, we are talking about preparedness. You know, what's the secret about that?
Thank you, Luis. Is there anything else you'd like to add before I turn the camera off?
Well, thank you, James Law, for making this possible. And I'm going to copy your idea, so stay tuned. I'm going to see more interviews coming from Innovarte.